Ubuntu 24.04 has been released, and it's not just another release, it's LTS, means long time support, and so we can expect that it will be around with us for quite a while. So today, I wanted to show you how you can install it as a virtual machine on Proxmox 8.2.2, which by the way was also recently released. So how do we do that? Well, we first have to download the ISO, the image of the Ubuntu itself. So what I will do, I will just go to Google and search for Ubuntu 24.04. Let's go for that first link at the very top. And first thing I noticed, it's much larger in size than the previous one, 22.04 LTS. It's over 6 gig, as you can see. But never mind, let's download it. That might take a while. And now when it's done, I can go back to Proxmox and upload that ISO image. So I've got the previous one, Ubuntu 22. As you can see, it's 3.8 gig. I will choose upload. I will find my file in downloads. And you can see this one is 6.1 gig. So quite a difference here. And then just click upload. The task was okay. That's what you want to see. So we can close it now. And we've got that ISO now available within Proxmox. We can click Create VM. And my VMs usually start from 200. So this will be 205 because I already have 202, 203 and 204. So this will be next one up. I will name it Ubuntu 24.04. But it doesn't really matter what you put here. It's just for your information. We can click Next. And now the OS. What I have to do here is to just click the correct ISO image. And it's the one we've just downloaded, Ubuntu 24.04 desktop, AMD64. We leave everything else as it is and click Next again. In System section, I only click QEMU Agent, because that will help you with display resolution and some other aspects later on, for example in remote desktop sessions. So that's the only thing we have to do here, and we can click Next. For disks, it chooses 32 GB by default. You can go down to 25, but do not go any lower than that, because that's the minimum recommended size for Ubuntu 24. It used to be 20 for Ubuntu 22, but it's 25 for Ubuntu 24. And you might also want to click Discard, which is basically a trim option for your SSD drive. So with these two, I can click Next. Now the CPU. CPU, you basically, I mean at home, you should always choose Host, which you can do by clicking this drop-down arrow, then scroll to the very bottom, and here it is, Host. That basically means you kind of disable virtualization of the processor. And if you are unsure what it is about, remember that we always have that Help button in the down left corner. So if you click that, it will give you the instructions about the current tab you are working on. So if we search for the types of CPUs, like here, CPU type, you can see that QEMU can emulate a number of different CPUs, but here, in short, if you don't care about live migration, you can set the CPU type to Host, which will give you the maximum performance. So maybe your use case is different than mine, and maybe you want to virtualize processor, because maybe you care about live migrations. But because I don't, I always choose Host, so I always have maximum performance. Hope that makes sense. So we can go back, so it's Host, but I will also give it 4 cores, rather than just one. What you might also want to do is click that Advanced button. If you scroll down, there is an interesting option, allow guest OS to use 1 gig size pages, which might be a good option. I usually turn it on, but I will leave everything else as it is. But my point is, this stage is, it might be different for me than for you, but these are my settings and I will just click Next. Now memory, I have the ballooning device enabled, which means I can set up different maximum amount and I can then pick minimum memory used. My system can have kind of floating amount of RAM for this VM. If you can't see that ballooning device, it's probably because you don't have that advanced option clicked. I can click Next to network, and I don't want to change anything here in network portion. So I just click Next again. This is just overview of your settings. So you can just have a look again and click Finish if you're happy with that. My VM is being built, here on the left, 205. So you can either right-click on it to start it and to connect to the console, or you can just select it here and do the same using these buttons. So doesn't really matter, that's exactly the same. I will click Start here maybe, and once we can see green Play button, we can console to that machine. And it will ask us if we want to install Ubuntu. And that's what we want to do. I will click Enter. And now you will just follow standard installation process for Ubuntu 24. You just pick the language. Next. You can skip that. For me it's English UK. I am on wired connection right now. Click Next. And we need full installation. So I will leave it as it is. Install Ubuntu. By default, interactive installation is picked, and I'm okay with that. Apps, I don't care about any apps really, but never mind. And this is up to you, but I will click both of them, both of these options. And yes, that will erase the disk, 25 gig disk that we created in Proxmox. Happy with that. Click Next. My name is Marek. Computer, I will call it, I don't know, mini PC. And we'll choose the password for the system. That's it. Select your region here and just review the options. I'm happy with that, so I will install Ubuntu. This process will take a while, so I will fast forward it. And it took a while, over 10 minutes I think, but it's now completed, so we can restart now. You will see the message saying, please remove the installation medium, but you can ignore that, just press Enter. And that's it. I can now log on as user Marek and password that I've just created. You have the welcome message, and that's basically the process completed. There are some additional questions from Ubuntu, but no, I don't want to share the system data, and I will just finish it. So that's it for today, and thank you for watching.